what is this material? How do I even start? It's all around us, and yet, unlike so many of the common materials that we get to play with every day, the understanding of how sand moves is just so poor. It's one of the biggest open questions in science. Is it a solid? Is it a liquid? Or is it a gas? I think the truth of the matter is, it's really just all of the above. When I was a student, I would take classes where I would learn some kind of a general governing equation that explains how a material behaves in a general circumstance. This is true in fluids, this is true in solids, even quantum mechanics. And I was just astounded when I learned that there wasn't a similar set of equations that worked just as well for sand. I became enamored with this idea that, you know, maybe we could come up with the answer. One of the things that we knew was what a granular material does when it's put into simple shear and run to steady state. But what was weird was we also had some data in other cases, other geometries, which seemed to violate the rules that we saw in simple shearing. And I became very intimately engaged with all of those little violations. And in my heart, I knew that there just had to be a simple way to insert one extra non-local term. And if we got it right, I had a feeling that it could solve everything. I was inspired when I came across an approach that had been used previously for emulsions. And when I looked at that form, the light bulb went off and I said, something like that has to be behind granular materials. So I adopted the framework and changed all of the ingredients so that it might reflect sand. And we took this model that we had written, we tried it in every data set we could find in the literature. And we were just astounded when we saw that the model had predicted all of them. Just think about all the places that we deal with grains and all the ways that you could now design for those applications. Pills, powders, you know, food, raw materials. Think about all of the factories and plants that have to manipulate this material around, and just imagine that you can now design the equipment optimally. We have this tool we can actually, hopefully, quantitatively predict.